It was a typical Wednesday at the Atlanta Comedy Theater. And while filming my intro to the Kino Trice show with my cameraman Dawood, who's often mistaken for an extremely tall Mexican, this happened.
We were. Oh my God! My sister! Oh my God! It's my fucking sister! Oh!
Shit over here. I don't know what the fuck y'all had going on over there, but this is real family reunion type shit. You see, she didn't even recognize her sister at first. That would have never happened with niggas. You hear me? This is some real family reunion shit.
Oh my God, thank you. Oh, this is my baby sister.
Oh. Everybody record their shit. You ain't gonna better wear that outfit either.
Oh, that's so
Say
sweet.
Hi to Ma.
Hi, Mom.
they're gonna be like, who the fuck is Mom? This camera right here.
They haven't seen each other in years, man. This
is beautiful. He said he was gonna send it to you.
White people love you. White people are so sentimental and they cry.
You know what? We were just
like movies like Sleepless in Seattle and Saving Private Ryan. This goes out to you, white people.
All right. Oh,
oh, that's cool as hell.
Decided to surprise you.
Well, hey, Kenny, how are you?
I'm great.
Oh, nice meeting you. Aww, wow. You got a client.
Oh, my God. How long are you here for?
So probably just overnight, or we're supposed to go to Virginia tomorrow, but.
Oh, my God. You know what we need to do? We gotta get tattoos.
Y'all gotta get fucked up.
No, we gotta get tattoos.
When white people have a reunion, that's the type of shit they do.
I gotta get a feather.
We gotta get tattoos.
Oh, I don't know.
Get the fuck out of
here. I know. Sarah has hers too.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Kino Trice. I'm in the building with Janet Dollar. I can't believe it.
What up?
She's been showing out. She's been showing out the whole time, so.
No, I have not. Yeah. I have been sitting here being patient. I was just praying before y'all started this camera. Don't do me like that.
If y'all haven't seen Janet Dollar, I mean, Beast on stage, I love the whistle.
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And I ain't gonna tell y'all about it. Y'all just gotta come out and see the whistle.
That's my trademark. Yeah.
The whistle is the shiznit.
Yes, yes. I'm trying to save lives one whistle at a time. That's it. Trying to stay on the road. I've been doing comedy for about 8.5 years now. You know, God is good. You know, when it's an anointing over your life, you just gotta work.
Right.
Faith without works is dead. So,
right.
Anything, I just try to put forth the best effort I can. I don't sleep. Right now,
I don't sleep either.
I know you don't. I see you out here in these streets, yeah. Making white folks mad. I feel the burn. Hashtag Bernie Sanders 2016. When he take Hillary by storm, yeah. They weren't expecting him to win Michigan, but fuck y'all. We took the water up there and we won that bitch.
Feel the burn.
Yeah, with his whole ass. Yeah.
Hang on, baby. We're gonna get about 6-7 months out of him,
yeah.
For the vice president, gotta take over. Who would have run for vice president?
He probably picked Hillary, man, the shaz.
Man, she gonna get in there regardless. The way she going, they probably could just give her another cabinet seat or something so she can lie.
They gonna build a cabinet on the wall and tell her to sit in that motherfucker.
So she can send out some more emails.
Yeah, on her personal phone. Right. With your lying ass.
Nah, she probably got a burner now. A throwaway. What? What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Where are you from originally?
I'm from LaGrange, Georgia. I moved to Atlanta probably about 15 years ago. I work at Morehouse School of Medicine by day. I've been working there for about 12 years.
Okay.
So it's incorporated and assisted me in doing a lot of corporate events, clean comedy. As dirty as a lot of y'all motherfuckers have seen me, I can do clean comedy. I've done churches. I've done children events. I did a comedy show. The weirdest shit I've ever done was I did a comedy show for a funeral director conference. All the funeral directors from a regional area here in Georgia, and it was like 150 funeral home directors there, and they wanted comedy. And I gave it to that dead ass.
Did everybody have black suits on?
Everybody was drunk and had black suits on. It was crazy. You paid me the right kind of money, I don't give a damn.
Yeah, now talk about that. As you've been doing it for 8 years. Like, 8 years, I know you've seen every room imaginable from the worst to the best. But the worst is always the funny stories to me. What's the worst place you've done comedy in?
Worst place I ever done comedy was Brookhaven, Mississippi. I got booked with two comics. I didn't even take my clothes off to sleep in the bed. I just took a nap. I slept with my clothes on. When we woke up and got ready to leave the fucking hotel, the lady that cleaned the rooms had a fucking grocery cart from the Winn-Dixie up the street. That's what the sheets and shit was being put in. So ask me, did the promoter have all my fucking money? What you think?
Nah, not with the grocery cart hotel.
He did not have all my money, so...
Was the show sold out?
Of course not. It looked like he didn't tell nobody but him and his homies. And that was, it was rough.
And how far is that drive from here?
About 7 hours. Oh. So it was some bullshit. It was some real bullshit. You know some bullshit when the promoter tell you he wants you to come see the club and he pull a pistol out of somebody in there. Trying to scare you because he know he ain't got all your money. Nigga, we can have a gunfight in this motherfucker. I drove here, so I got my piece. So we gonna have a shootout. You don't pay them niggas you know. You gonna pay me. I got my money. Them niggas was needing lunch money on the way back. Ah, fuck that. We can't play them kind of games.
Don't play with Janet. No.
And I got a husband now. And he don't play no games. So you book me, just have my money, that's all. I'm going to deliver, I promise you.
Oh, she will deliver.
I'm going to deliver, whistling all.
I'm going to give you that whistle in your ass.
Yeah, already. Yeah.
Cool, man. Like I said, see Janet Dollar, one of the funniest female comics in Atlanta.
I appreciate
no
it.
No gender, one of the funniest comics in Atlanta.
Straight up.
Straight up and down. So where can we find you on social media? What you got going on?
You know what? The funny part is, I don't know how to get people to go to my fan page other than tell y'all. My personal Facebook page is sold up. I got 5,000 friends. So please go to my fan page, Comedian. Comedian with the I-E-N-N-E on the end. Comedian Janet Dollar. That's my Facebook fan page. I'm also on Instagram and Twitter. You can follow me like a stalker. Shout out to stalkers. Keep looking for love. Persistence pays off. You ain't been loved till you been stalked, bitch. Get you a motherfucker to fall asleep watching you sleep, bitch. That's what I'm saying. Get a nigga that's persistent in his love. I'm not on that other shit. I'm not on Tinder, none of that other shit. I don't date a lot anymore. I'm married now, so you do still have a chance, depending on how many bills you want to pay. He down with that shit too. So a lot of people tell you, comedy is you got to have a lot of balls.
Yeah.
Even women, it's even tougher for us in the game. So you got to make your mark and you got to roll with it. So
no fear.
Not if you've been given a gift. Why are you going to... You have to... People be wondering why a lot of people are successful. They wonder why specific people are successful and a lot of other people don't gain that success. Faith without works is dead. You got to show and prove every day. Even when you ain't got no gas in your car, even though you ain't got no money to do other stuff with, you got to have faith in your talent. When you have faith in your talent, God is looking down and saying, you know what? That nigga believe in the gift that I gave him, and I'm going to bless him, and he's going to bless you abundantly. So whatever you're doing, whether you're singing, doing poetry, selling dope, doing embalming motherfuckers, just do it to the best of your ability, and I guarantee you everything is going to come out to the T. I promise you. That ain't me. That's written in the Word. Whether you believe in whatever, it's a higher power. You believe it's going to happen. Just stay working.
Plant that seed and it shall grow.
Plant that seed. That motherfucker might not grow for 3-4 years. Yeah. I met a promoter about 4 years ago in Charlotte, North Carolina at the CIAA. Shout out to Nina Dawkins in Philly, Trenton, Charlotte. She didn't let me perform that night. I was really mad. I had drove all the way to Charlotte. Some real high-end niggas came in, Talent, Joe Torre, and they took over the show. I wasn't able to perform. 3 years later, she called me, and she put me on a show. She put me on a show every year in Trenton for Women's Month. Shout out to all the women this Women's Month. I'm finna stop talking y'all to death.
That's how it is. This is Janet. This is Janet Dollar. And the moral of that story is, you better have her money.
Yeah.
Janet Dollar, ladies and gentlemen. And thanks for coming through.
Absolutely. Y'all keep fucking with my dude and dude behind the camera. Y'all knew it. What's your name?
Dawoo.
Dawoo. That name alone will get him a lot of pussy. So anybody want to know who Dawoo is, hit up Kino. He gonna let you know who Dawoo is with the long hair. And the Dawoo, you know, you whisper that in a bitch ear, she's bound to throw her panties at you. So shout out to Dawoo, the cameraman, Kino. Y'all keep supporting black comedy, supporting comedy, period. It's a lot of funny motherfuckers out here. We got to take a lot of nuts to get on stage. So just keep supporting the dream. Whatever you do, just keep working. Be persistent at it, consistent. And everything will pay off in the end. Can I take that home?
That's it. Hey, and don't belong to me. I ain't seen nothing. Peace!
Take more than a road trip for me to feel like I'm homesick. On Instagram, but don't post it. Cause I don't trust most cats I toast with. This ain't personal, but it's personal. If you cross the line, it gets worse though. I got an entourage, but I'm dolo. Know I need church, but I don't go. 100 miles ain't too far. Speed demon in a blue car. Me and you are like two stars. We shine bright, but we so far. Relationship is like seesaw. Straw hat like hee-haw. When I pull up in that blue car, you can jump right in, I'ma peel off.